Alice, I'm happy to read this poem about Pride and Prejudice and Wuthering Heights. Okay. So we've had a lot of fun, Alice and I, with our team Wuthering Heights and our team Austin. And it's all in good fun, but it is true that to begin with, I was like, I don't want to do Wuthering Heights. I really don't like it. But again, you know, Alice's passion for this book, it's sort of rubbing off on me. The weather this morning, I was like, oh, this makes me want to stand on a moor. But yes, when I told my friend about this ongoing debate, she wrote the following, and she's even revised it since yesterday, so especially toward the end. I have heard of the passion for Wuthering Heights, where poor Heathcliff wanders the moor, the hill, nursing his tragic, unrealized love for Catherine, whose ghostly image haunts him still. The argument is made that the Brontes are gritty, are real in their emotions. I'd say it's escapist at most. Because in stark, honest reality, in the daylight, who among us has ever genuinely met a ghost? And I can't agree it's tragic Heathcliff lost Catherine. After she came home, supposedly genteel and refined, then shows bad manners by laughing at his efforts to be like her. It shows she was not much improved in her mind. But Bronte characters seldom improve. Well, they're characters. They are all static, strong personality types that come across to me as caricatures. In spite of all the gritty realism hype, they're not people I'd want to meet in real life. Rossetti called it a fiend of a book, an incredible monster, and that the action is laid in hell. Only it seems place and people have English names there, where these caricatures dwell. Charlotte, Emily's sister, wrote that in reading Austin, that author was true to life, but she found little of the passion. Nothing profound in the way of a stormy sisterhood, but Miss Bronte must lay down her bloody, wide-swung battle axe long enough to realize that a well-placed rapier thrust can cut just as deep past the surface, if only one takes the time to look. And perhaps more skill. Jane Austen, in her miniature delicacy, was so talented to be able to create in her mind these stories that was perhaps about the everyday, the plain, but showed development and growth in her characters to both ably uplift and entertain at the same time. That's not easy to do, and do well. Both stories have been enjoyed over the years, but I appreciate a chance, with Lizzie Bennet, to laugh at the silliness of humanity, instead of tasting only bitter tears. We all find ourselves in the dark and lonely places, but it's not anywhere I choose to stay. How did we come by the mistaken notion that dark in literature, or in art, implies deeper, anyway? Or again, how is it more realistic? I know I cannot be, and am not the only one, to have thought this. Jane herself wrote Northanger Abbey, poking gentle fun at the Gothic genre, which is now again in fashion, and showing how the prosaic, the real, may look faded against the imaginative, but over passion, just looks ridiculous. Or in cases, unhealthy. Such as in Sense and Sensibility, when Marianne almost makes herself sick to the point of death in her sorrow, rejected by a faithless man. If she knew all about him, she might have rejected him. And when push comes to shove, Jane herself dryly observed in letters, people seldom actually die for love. In any event, Austin herself was not the only one that the stormy sister Charlotte Bronte hated. She also criticized Wuthering Heights, and no doubt it right Heathcliff was ever created. So if a stormy sisterhood by nature or by birth is not enough for even a Bronte anyway, I don't know what the debate is all about. Give me Pride and Prejudice any day.